This is a great storm here in the Denver area and along the Front Range, but in the western part of the state, they're going, what's the big deal? It's drier out there because this is a classic upslope storm. Northeast winds blowing into the Denver area. The mountains force their air to rise, squeeze out all the moisture, and we get all of the snow while they're partly cloudy on the west side of the state. Look at this upslope developing over the Denver area. This view from City Park earlier this evening. Some of the numbers you already have, we're getting close to a half a foot or more of snow in some locations west and south of Denver. Farther to the north and east, not all that much. Greeley's had about an inch or two. Denver 7 Studios just around an inch of snow. So the farther west and south that you go to the higher elevations, that's where you get more of the moisture. Corey Reppenhagen has more on that as he is right in the middle of that deep upslope flow. Corey?
Yeah, Mike, I'm at the Boulder Overlook right now. We've got some pretty good snow going. You can see the wind just blowing it across your screen there. We do have a little bit of accumulation out here on the grassy areas, just about an inch or so, but notice nothing on the sidewalks or the asphalt just yet. It's going to take a while for those temperatures and those snowfall rates to overcome these wet grounds out here, but we are below freezing right now, and those temperatures, those road temperatures, are falling. So in the morning, we'll have some very wet, slick travel in the morning. Now, the big story might be the temperatures as we drop into the middle 20s here. Those plants need to already be protected, but your underground pipes, those should be okay. Your sprinkler systems, it's the above ground pipes that are exposed that need to be protected by a blanket. Your sprinkler system should be off right now. Mike, we've still got some pretty good snow going out here, but there is still time. If you want to run out and protect a pipe, you've still got a little bit of time here before those temperatures get into the danger zone, Mike.
Just as soon as the newscast is over. Great work. Thanks, Corey. Let me show you what's happening right now. 31 downtown, 30 at DIA. You can see the slick-looking streets. It's just wet right now, but as the temperatures fall, especially bridges and ramps are going to ice up first because they have that air that circulates underneath them. Winds are screaming in from the northeast at 23, dropping the wind chill to 17. We hit 54 before the cold front moved in, and the low is the current reading of 30. There's the snow. Now, it's much less up here. Remember that upslope flow pushing that moisture up to the higher elevations to the south and to the west of the Denver area. What happens tonight? Watch on the future cast. You'll be able to see there's that moisture coming in, that upslope flow indicated by the wind arrow. So we see the heavier snow Boulder County, down into Jefferson County, Douglas County, southern Arapahoe County. And by tomorrow morning, it's really shifting down to the south over southeastern Colorado. They're going to get a huge storm down there, maybe a foot of snow. Great news for the farmers and ranchers because they've been in drought conditions. 25 for the low in Denver, 15 at Leadville, 24 degrees out on the plains at Akron. Front Range numbers all cold enough tomorrow morning to give you icy conditions. If you want to head up and ski, if you can get up there, it's going to be a great powder day at A Basin, Mary Jane, and at Loveland. Now, there's tomorrow at 6 a.m. Still going to have that snow falling through the midday hour. It starts to diminish a little as the main storm drops down to the southeast, but even through the evening, we'll have periods of snow showers. As far as the accumulation, you can see the heaviest activity down here over southeastern Colorado and on the south and west side of the Denver metro area. Those are the big numbers, a foot to 16 inches across the mountains, 6 to 10 down to the south, just 2 to 4 the farther to the north and east that you get. Overnight tonight, it's going to be wet, heavy, snow, windy, colder, and 25. For tomorrow, the high temperature only at 35 with periods of snow gradually diminishing, but it stays windy and cold. Sunday morning, a chiller down to the low 20s, mostly sunny in the afternoon, 52. Partly cloudy skies Monday and Tuesday will melt off a lot of this snow with temperatures in the mid to upper 50s. Some showers possible Wednesday, but by next Thursday and next Friday, a very different weather pattern. We'll be talking about sunshine, 60s to mid 70s.
Yeah, gotta love this Colorado weather. That's indeed what we expect. Craziness. Yeah. Thank
all
you,
about
Mike.
The weather.